Yeah, I gotta admit, the weather has been odd of late. But you know, this is nothing compared to the year 1816. That was the year without a summer. The Warner Town history, and by the way, we are in Warner. This is the Dalton-covered bridge. The town history in this town has an account of 1816 that is as graphic as any I've ever found. The beginning of the year gave no indication as what was to come. January, February were, in fact, mild. March of that year, however, made up for the mildness of the previous months, with temperatures well below normal and gusting winds all month. The first week of April was mild, but as the month progressed, it got colder and colder and colder, and by May 1st, after a thaw, half an inch of ice formed on the local ponds. Buds, flowers, killed by the cold. Not one day in May was mild, and the first week in June saw a 4-inch snowfall. On the 5th of July, ice the thickness of window glass formed on the ponds in New York State and all over New England. It melted, but there were a series of hard frosts that year. August was no better, in fact, worse. During the first week, ice formed on Pleasant Pond to a depth of a full 1/4 inch. Crops failed all up and down the East Coast, from Maine to Virginia. Many had to sell their farms. Many went hungry. People, in fact, took to calling the year 1800 and starved to death. Seed corn prices rose to $5 a bushel. The only break in the weather that year was during the first 2 weeks of September, when the temperature rose to seasonal highs. But then the ice came back in the second half with a vengeance and stayed through October. An early snowstorm in November dumped a full 1 foot of snow, enough to get the sleighs out. But in December, the snow melted, and then the rest of the winter was one of the mildest on record. Not incidentally, the next year, the first great migration west occurred. People all over New England pulled up stakes and went out to Kansas and Indiana. Oh yeah, what caused the year without a summer? Well, scientists today think it was 3 great volcanic eruptions in the Far East, one in the Philippines, 2 in Indonesia, that spewed volcanic dust into the atmosphere and blocked the sun. Although the east coast of the United States was hit hard, there was also extreme cold all over the northern hemisphere, including England and the rest of Europe. And that's the story of the year without a summer, 1800 and starved to death. That is 1816.